This video takes a brief look at the six correlation techniques that we have in the SPC for Excel software package. These are accessed under the statistical tools on the SPC for Excel menu by selecting correlation. We have correlation coefficients, failure mode and effects analysis, scatter plot matrix, plotting multiple Y values against one X values, BACI charts, and also waterfall charts. We're going to start with correlation coefficients. Suppose we want to see if there's a correlation between three factors: hardening temperature, tempering temperature, and hardness of some steel bar. What you do then, you've got and take some measurements. You measure hardening temperature, tempering temperature, and the resulting hardness, and you do this for a number of different data sets. You enter your data into an Excel spreadsheet. You then simply select the data, including the titles. You go to the SPC for Excel ribbon. We're going to go to correlation, and we're going to do correlation coefficients, and you select OK. And it brings up, and we have the range already selected. If that's not correct, you can change it. Select OK, and we have our correlation coefficient output, where we have the value of R and the probability. And a probability less than 0.05 means that it's a significant correlation. Those are turned to red as well. So you see most of these are significantly correlated. 0.06 is also very close. So that's how you do a correlation coefficient analysis in the SPC for Excel software. The next technique we want to look at is the failure mode and effects analysis. You simply go to the correlation panel up in the SPC for Excel ribbon. I'm going to select failure mode and effects analysis, select OK, and this generates the template where you can come in and do your analysis. And you can see here, you come in, you have what the process, potential failure mode, potential effects on the failure mode. Then you have severity ratings, and you can enter these and the possible causes. And you can see then that we fill them out over here, and then they actually go ahead and calculate the risk priority number. And then we have areas down here where you can do your put in your action steps. So this is a failure mode and effects analysis template that's built into the SPC for Excel software program. The third technique we want to take a look at is how you plot multiple Y variables against one X variable. Suppose we have some data where over time we're measuring intensity in amps, and we have an experimental measurement, and we also have a theoretical. And we want to see how those look together. We simply enter our data into an Excel spreadsheet, just like we did with the correlation coefficients, select the data, then we go to the correlation menu, and we're going to select plot multiple Y variables against one X variable, select OK. And it comes up and gives you the information that you need to enter. You have your ranges already selected. We'll enter a title. We'll just call this test. And we select OK. And it generates our chart for us, where it compares for the time down here, the X values, and the two Y values as shown here, experimental, theoretical. And you see the experimental and theoretical agree fairly well. Fourth technique we want to take a look at is the scatter plot matrix. Suppose we want to see if there's a relationship between delivery time and how many cartons a person has to deliver and the distance they have to walk. So we've collected some data on that, and then we're going to generate a scatter plot for each of the possible combination of two. So you select your data, and then you come up and you select from the SPC menu, you select correlation, and we're going to do scatter plot matrix. Select OK. It comes in and gives you the range selected, including the headings. It gives you the output options. We can have best fit line equation, including R-squared. And we're just going to include the best fit line in R-squared. And we select OK. And what happens is it gives us a scatter plot matrix. Here's the y-axis, for example, delivery time. And then here it is versus cartons. And here it is versus distance. And you can see the R-squared values are fairly high, so there's a pretty good correlation. This one down here has cartons on the y-axis and delivery time and distance on the x-axis, and then down here distance is on the y-axis and cartons and delivery times are on the x-axis. So you can easily see a correlation if there one exists between multiple variables using the scatter plot matrix. The next correlation technique we want to take a look at is the waterfall chart. For example, suppose we have some profit information. We have our sales in 2007, which were 7.98, and here's how the sales changed, what the sales were for our various products in 2008, and we want to see what impact they had on the profit graphically, and the waterfall chart's a great way to do that. So you enter your information into the Excel spreadsheet as seen here. Here we have our product A, 2.3 million, etc. We go to correlation on the SPC for Excel ribbon, and we select waterfall chart and select OK. And we need a name for the chart, waterfall. This chart can be updated with new data. And We select, that's all we really need. We'll just leave everything else the same. Select OK, and we have our profit information chart where we have sales in 2007, where they ended up in 2008. And we can see the products that impacted it positively are in green. Those that impacted it negatively are in red. So this gives you a picture of how what caused that sales from 2007 to grow in 2008. The last correlation technique we're going to take a look at is called the BACI chart. And this chart is useful to see if perhaps a process change has an impact on various machines and when it has that. So what we do is we have some data here where we have some baseline data and data on machines 1 and 2. And what we do is simply select all that data. And there's quite a bit because we have made some changes, but you'll see how you see the changes in just a second as we go through this. And then you come back to the SPC for Excel ribbon, select the correlation. It's going to be BACI charts, and we select OK. And you come up with your options. We'll just call it BACI. And here's your identifier ranges. Then you have your baseline data. You can have control limits, and we're going to set our baseline data to be the control limits. And then we have our comparison data range, where we're going to compare what happens to machines 1 and 2. And then we have our titles. We simply select OK, and it brings up our completed chart. And you can see this is where our baseline here, and it goes suddenly up to here. Here's machine 1 now. We've made the change to machine 1, and it comes up. And here's machine 2. We make the change to machine 2, and it comes up. So you can see easily the impact of the changes using the BACI chart. So that's the correlation techniques that are in the SPC for Excel software package. Thank you for watching the video.